7. Philippians 4, 6, and 7. Philippians. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, thanksgiving, present your request to God.
Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything,
by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. The peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus.
Do not be
anxious
about
anything,
but in
everything, by prayer and petition, thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. The peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus.
Twenty-five. morning, everyone. Welcome back to West Hills Presbyterian Church Sunday School, where we worship the true and the living God. Are you guys ready to worship? All right, hands together, eyes closed, and let's pray. Lord Jesus, thank you once again for allowing us to gather here today. We know that you are living and you are mighty and you hear our prayers. I pray today, Lord, that you would teach us what it means to pray to this living God who hears all of our prayers. And I pray, Lord God, as Jesus prayed, that you would teach us to pray and that we would abide in you and worship you. We thank you that you are in complete control over every single thing in our lives. And we want to thank you that you are a good God, and everything that is in our lives is for our good and for your glory. Thank you, Jesus, and in your precious name we pray. And everybody said, Amen. I have a question for you today. Who do you talk to the most? Think about it. For me, I'm always talking. I'm talking to my kids. I'm always talking to my husband and talking. But do you know who I talk to the most? Yes, it's God. And you are thinking, how's that possible? Well, we are going to learn today about what Jesus taught about prayer. Everyone, let's recite the Lord's Prayer. Do you guys remember the Lord's Prayer? The one that we say at the end of every service? Well, today we get to learn what that means. So everybody, let's say the Lord's Prayer together. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as we have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. While Jesus was on earth, he taught how for people to be able to go to the kingdom of God. He also taught about heaven and who God the Father is. He also taught us how to pray. Today in Luke chapter 11, the disciples saw that Jesus was praying and they asked him, Lord, teach us how to pray. And this is what Jesus said. So same thing in Luke and same thing in Matthew 6 verse 9 through 13. This is the Lord's Prayer. And our Father in heaven, that's how it starts. Now, this was profound for many people because how dare you call God your father? And that word father means daddy, Abba. How dare you call God, the creator of the universe, daddy? But do you know that you and I can? Why? It's because of Jesus. We are now part of God's family because Jesus, the Son of God, died on the cross. And he died for your sins and my sins. And those of us that have accepted Jesus as their Lord and Savior can call God Abba, Father. And this is what Jesus was teaching. That many people pray, many religions pray. However, God of this universe only hears prayers that is prayed through Jesus, because Jesus is the only Son of God. So, do you want to pray? Do you want to petition to God? First and foremost, do you have Jesus in your hearts? And if you have Jesus in your heart, do you know what that means? God promised the Holy Spirit to be living in us, and he will teach us how to pray. and He teaches us the will of the Father so that we know what to pray for, when to pray for, and how to pray. Isn't this just amazing that we can call the Creator of the whole universe Daddy? And not only that, we know that He hears our prayers. In other parts of the Bible, God says, call upon me and I will hear your prayers. In Psalms 91:15, this is what God says. When He, that means us, calls on Him, He will hear our prayers. Not only do we get to call God Abba Father, but we know that He hears our prayers. And when we pray, do you know how we pray? The first thing is not, Daddy, Daddy, I need this, I need that. No, we tell God back who He is. By reading the Bible, we know about who God is. And we say, God, you're amazing, you're wonderful, you are mighty, you are powerful, you are the Creator. And when we start our prayers by worshiping God and exalting and praising His name, that's how God, that's how Jesus taught us to pray. And after we say how great He is, then we say, your kingdom come, your will be done. Meaning, we're not going to pray what we want, what we think is best, because we're only mere little beings, but God, you are an amazing God, and you know exactly what is needed in every single circumstance. So we want your will, your plan, your thoughts to happen on earth. And after that, we say, give us this day our daily bread. We petition our Abba Father, saying, God, we have this need. I see my friend and he has this need. Please hear our prayers. And then we pray of repentance and forgiveness. Forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. We're always praying to God and asking for forgiveness for the things that we have done wrong, things that we should have done that we did not do. And do you know what? Every single time, God hears even these prayers and forgives us because of Jesus. So you guys, after adoration, exalting God and telling God back who He is, and petition, asking the Lord, please help with our needs, and confession, God, please forgive us, right? And then we continuously pray, persistently, without giving up, without stopping. Our key verse today says, pray without ceasing. What that means is we shouldn't stop praying. Did you know that was possible? Absolutely. Through the power of the Holy Spirit, we could be praying at all times. Matter of fact, we should be praying without stopping. There's so many uncertainties. There's so many things around us that we cannot control. But do you know, we know our Daddy, our Heavenly Father, and He is in control and He knows it all, and that we bring anything up to Him continuously, persistently, petitioning and asking and begging and pleading for His mercy. And with faith, understanding that because it's not our merits that God hears us, it's because of His Son. That's why we can boldly go to Jesus and say, please, Father, help us, save us, rescue us, open the door, close the door, make the way possible. What is it that God is calling you to pray? What have you been praying for? From here today, always start your prayers with adoration, worshiping God and praising His name. And then you bring humbly your petition, but always ending with, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. That only His plan, your plan, God, would take place. And always confessing our sins every single day and knowing that God forgave us all of our sins. So you guys, let's stand up and let's end our service by praying this prayer together. Shall we?
1, 2, 3. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as we have forgiven our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. And everybody said, amen.
I hope this week, the one person that you talk to the most is Jesus. Have a victorious week in the Lord. Bye now.
Jesus had just finished praying when one of his disciples said, Lord, teach us to pray. So Jesus told them, when you pray, say, Father, your name be honored as holy. Your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread and forgive us our sins, for we ourselves also forgive everyone in debt to us. And do not bring us into temptation.
Then Jesus told them a story. Imagine one of you goes to a friend at midnight and says, Friend, let me borrow 3 loaves of bread because a friend of mine has traveled to visit me and I don't have anything to offer him. The friend shouts from inside his house, Go away, my family is in bed. I don't want to get up to help you.
What?
Even though the man does not want to help his friend, he will get up and give his friend what he needs because he asked boldly.
Jesus told the story to teach the disciples about prayer. He said, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. Jesus asked, does any father when his son asks for a fish give him a snake instead? Or if the son asks for an egg, does the father give him a scorpion? Jesus said that fathers who are sinners know how to give good gifts to their children. God is an even greater Father. He gives the Holy Spirit to those who ask.
Jesus told another story, a parable, to teach the disciples to pray without giving up. In a town was a judge who did not care about God or people. Over and over, a widow went to the judge and asked him to protect her from wrongdoing. The judge did not want to help, but after a while he said, I will give this widow what she wants so she does not keep bothering me. Jesus pointed out that the unjust judge did what was right because the widow did not give up. When people cry out to God day and night, will he ignore them? Jesus asked. No, he will quickly make things right. Jesus wanted his followers to have faith that doesn't give up.
Jesus taught us to pray. Because of Jesus, we can pray to God as a father and ask for what we need. We can trust that God is good and loving, and we can count on Him to do what is right.